Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today is a day a lot of people have been waiting for. Our first major piece of news about WWE 2K19 was finally released today, and honestly, it's a big one because it's a brand new game mode called Towers. All right, so I have I feel like there's so much to talk about right now, and honestly, I'm really happy about that. I have the blog in front of me that they posted. I'm gonna link it down in the description below. I'm basically gonna go through some of the highlights of it and talk about exactly what this mode is. All right, so everyone's heard of the AJ Styles Million Dollar Tournament and whatever, right? Well, basically, the crux of the tournament exists inside this new mode called Towers. So let me go through real quick and talk a little bit more about what this mode is. Also on your screen is gonna be some screenshots of some of the screens from this mode, and you get a look at some of the in-game renders, and Jinx's My Career character actually looks pretty dope. So there are two types of towers in WWE 2K19. There's a gauntlet, and there's a steps. In steps, players climb their way through one match at a time at their own pace. The gauntlet, however, is an entire session where you face person after person after person, and quitting early or losing results in you losing completely. You gotta start back over again. Some towers are gonna feature their own sets of goals, including like challenges, gotta get specific scores, all that type of stuff. Some matches are even gonna have stipulations, so you might have, last man standing or Hell in a Cell. A few examples also include starting a match with a finisher or an event starting with health in the red. So it's gonna put you in different types of situations in these different matches. Towers mode features also many different match types: steel cage, table, submission, Iron Man, falls count anywhere, etc. So, in 2K Towers, players choose a WWE superstar to compete against a wide range of other superstar opponents across a number of challenging towers, and each tower has a unique theme, which is focused on showcasing the roster it includes or pays homage to a specific match type. For example, inside the 2K Towers, there's gonna be a legend lore, which is a feature that highlights the history. Listen to this. It's a feature that highlights the history and accomplishments of the undeniable legends featured in 2K19. That sounds a little like Showcase, doesn't it? Because Showcase was usually to feature a specific event or accomplishment based around, a certain set of superstars or one superstar or whatever. Maybe this is kind of like pulling some features from Showcase mode that people like without actually bringing it back all the way. I don't know, that's just my guess at this point. Now, as far as the AJ Million Dollar Tower, right? So this is the big one that everyone's freaking out about. Everyone wants to win $1 million, right? This tower apparently is not for the weak at heart, and it'll take extra determination and willpower to conquer it in full. Not only are the opponents in this tower a collection of some of WWE's finest, but they're also set at higher difficulties. Finally, your health will not regenerate in between matches, so those who persevere and manage to make it through this gauntlet will be rewarded handsomely. Now, in order to take part in the challenge though, they gave you a little more information on how to do that. So step one obviously is to beat AJ's Million Dollar Tower playing on either PS4 or Xbox One. Step two is to record yourself cutting a promo on why you have what it takes to beat AJ in 2K19. And step three is you visit 2k.com/MillionDollarChallenge to submit your promo video. Then from there, they'll pick finalists, fly them out, you gotta compete against one another, and then the final person competes against AJ Styles for $1 million. That's kinda crazy. Okay, moving forward a little bit, let's talk about this My Player Tower, because as most people know, My Player, My Career, that's kinda my bread and butter around here. So, in My Player Towers, players will use their My Players to battle through towers crafted to challenge both new and experienced players. In addition to a set of permanent towers, players are gonna find unique daily, weekly, and even pay-per-view based towers. Now this is the line that made me the happiest out of this entire page and this entire set of news. This next little bit. Every single day, a new tower will appear for players to take on. While every week there'll be a new weekly tower that's a bit longer than the daily tower, so be sure to start early. So what they're basically saying is that every single day, there's gonna be new content in the game, which is a huge step forward, because one of this game's biggest issues for years has been, after about a month and a half, there's nothing left to do. You know what I mean? You basically have done it all. So this hopefully will kind of expand the game's life cycle. This is good. In my opinion, this is good. So, I'm 100% here for that. Stars earned from these towers count toward all pay-per-view events and Road to Glory qualifications, so it's a good idea to tackle these as often as possible. So obviously, Road to Glory, is returning. Finally, pay-per-view towers are active alongside WWE's pay-per-view schedule. To qualify, you need to meet a specific star requirement. So honestly, kind of just like Road to Glory, but within its own type of... This almost seems like an offline Road to Glory, in a way. It's what it feels like. Just my opinion. But that's that. That's basically everything from this blog. I cover the challenge, all the different types of towers. So this is interesting. A lot of people had a lot of assumptions for what this was going to be. It was going to be some sort of crossover between like 2K19 and Supercard in some way. But the brand new towers mode in 2K19 is coming, and I'm intrigued. I'll be honest, I'm intrigued. Not gonna jump too far ahead of myself. We know how the things go sometimes, but I'm excited about that because, as I said, it sounds like there's gonna be a lot of new content coming down the pipeline into the game, and that makes me happy. So let me know what you guys think about all this down in the comment section below. Let me know if I missed anything or if I'm overlooking something. And tell me if you're excited. Tell me if you're hyped about 2K19. Hit that thumbs up button as hard as you possibly can. Make sure you're subscribed with notifications turned on. Click that little bell so you never miss an upload. I upload every single day. Don't miss it, y'all. I'll see you next time. Peace.